fine political forum in Nigeria where we discuss issues regarding job employment, politics, and policies as they affect the Nigerian populace. And my name is Deborah Yusuf. Today, we will be talking about another very trending issue that everyone that has been on the lips of everyone in the country during the week. I have with me today my guest, engineer Debo Onifade. Welcome to the show, engineer.
Thank you so much. Nice to see you again. How are you doing?
Yeah, it's a pleasure. I'm fine. How are you too?
Good.
Okay, so let's dive straight into the business of the day because of our time. Last week we were talking, the talk of the former EFCC chairman, that's Ibrahim Magu, feel the air of him being called out for corruption and embezzlement of funds and so many infractions by the Attorney General of the Federation, that's Abubakar Malami. And then after that, the president also suspended him from being the acting chairman of the commission. Well, during the week, precisely yesterday, he was released from detention. And then he made a statement. He said something about his detentions and the allegations that were made against him. And he said something that really caught my attention that I want us to talk about. He said, he described the allegations now as a case of dogs eat dogs. And then he said he sees all of those things as one of the risks that come with the job, that everything, all the allegations leveled against him were nonsense and didn't make sense. We're just to tarnish his image and all of that. So there's been so many discussions regarding this. This part that the EFCC chairman being indicted is a taint on the image of the country, like a commission that is meant to fight corruption, being held for corruption. Okay. And now he's coming to say it is not true. And he's been released from detention. So who do you think is on the wrong side? Is it the government who is probing him and accusing him of misdeeds? Or you think he's simply being a good man that he is?
So thank you so much. For now, I'm still on the side of Ibrahim Magu.
Okay.
I don't want to defend him so much like as if it's my twin brother.
Okay.
But I clearly still think that he's an innocent man. I think the EFCC as an organization has made certain errors in the last couple of years. Maybe some people under him have done some things wrong. But as a person, I still have this gut feeling that he's innocent. I've talked to a few of my friends and they're not. I see what's happening. I think that the Attorney General has personal plans.
Issues with him,
and so he wants to run the EFCC the way his own way. He has been able to get the government to support him, and that's what we have to live with. It's very unfortunate that. We have a government, the Buhari government, that is fighting against corruption. And you would detain a man for 10 days, and probably not allow him even say anything for.
Yeah, that's one of the things that people really did find wrong.
For
that
six
you
of
detain
these
two. Him. Yes, yeah, you detain him
for 6 or 7 of the 10 days. You wouldn't even allow him talk to the panel and. You haven't even confronted him with the allegations. And you know what? I knew something was amiss when I started seeing allegations flying around. And you can actually see some of them are hard to believe. You know, there's usual social media gossips. If you follow politics, you wouldn't. There's some of them that were obvious. And so if government begins to fly around some obvious lies like that, it's difficult for me to believe even the weighty allegations. You understand? So some of them are easy to refute. So for me, I still think I'm on the side of Ibrahim Magu. And again, look at how the newspapers were awash with a lot of funny news. I was talking to some of my friends in some newspapers. I don't want to mention it. And I was actually accusing them of being part of the cabal. And one or two of them said, no, this is true. And I'm saying, okay, but look at this one, two, three specific comments that are absolutely false. You know, and you have an IG that said, no, I'm not the one that arrested you. Talk to the panel. And then panel says, oh, we didn't order you to be detained for 10 days. So it seems to me like the DIG, specifically that DIG is the one in getting approval from the government as well as AG, Attorney General, okay. He has chosen to deal with Magu whichever way he wants to. I think the saddest part for me, though, is the fact that his security details were withdrawn. That saddened me. You know, in the night, I was telling my wife, I'm so concerned for this guy. She was like, hey, sleep. What's
up
with you?
He could be in danger, right?
Exactly. I was so concerned for him. This is a guy that has been fighting, powerful forces for years. Hmm. No matter what he has done, it's the responsibility of his employers, which in this case is federal government and IG, to protect him. And I think that's unfair to him. But ultimately, if he ends up being adjudged to have wronged, he should be reprimanded. He should be
and that's what I want us to talk about, Mr. Engineer Onifade. Now, I read an article, a statement of the DSS, where they stated out the supposed allegations that they had against them, and one of it was that he was working hands in hands with a known criminal, someone who's known for so many other frauds. So should we then conclude that perhaps he did part of what he is accused of, or maybe not as large as they claim it is?
So the DSS one is an old accusation, and that's already been refuted. You know, I think the new ones are different from the DSS ones. The DSS ones were technically nonsense, you know. But the recent ones, there are a few of the allegations that are weighty. That's correct. And it's my view that if it comes out true that he embezzled funds, I feel he should be reprimanded. He should be should be charged to court, and he should face the court just like every normal Nigerian. So that's my view on that. However, I think we should be fair to him. If we're fair to a lot of other people, I think it's important for the guy to be protected. And I think that, you know, let him be tried properly and not in the media. That's my view.
Well, that's quite unfortunate that as a government official and an office holder now, you simply get news of your promotion or demotion on social media. There's no official statement made anymore. Okay, let's move away from that to the Nigerian economy and job employment, which is one of the purposes of this show. The Presidential Gold Mining Development Initiative presented a locally mined gold bar to the president during the week. And the president made a statement. He says he promised now to establish gold refineries in Nigeria. And he also stated that this refineries and this industry, if well maximized, will provide 250,000 jobs for the country, Nigeria. So I think that's quite an achievement for the country. Like, you know, we are gradually shifting our focus from crude oil, and you know, we are maximizing opportunities in other industries. But then I have a fear that I want you to talk about. Isn't this going to be another means of siphoning funds for some people, like we are currently having with the NDDC?
So I think the Buhari government is not a honest government. I think they lie a lot.
Okay.
This is 6 years. They've been talking about solid minerals, mining. Nothing significant has happened in terms of actual job creation, signing major, don't let me talk about signing contracts. They've signed a lot of contracts, but it's 6 years is a long time. What do you think is causing the violence in Zamfara? There's so many locations. Exactly. The illegal mining has been going on for decades. This government hasn't fixed it in 6 years. I'm sure they will not fix it in 8 years. So they shouldn't even come and tell me. I talked about it in my book, Liberating Nigeria, a guide to winning elections and, reviving our country. Like, my book, it wasn't only about politics. I discussed policies from, devoted more chapters to policies than politics. And I talked about it. And I said, there's a restructuring part of it, which I don't want to talk about today. But, which includes empowering the state to be able to license mining companies, centralizing the mining right now, it's not good for everybody. You have to go through several years, but I believe that while we still wait for restructuring, for that structure to be taken care of, there are many things that can be done. I'm focused on the jobs. Like, when I discuss the economy, I'm always focused on jobs. It's nothing, to discuss about GDP, all those nonsense data. If you're not creating jobs, I disagree with a lot of people. Just go look at what the government has just said. Now, what is their strategy to create these jobs? I have not seen any in the last 6 years. Governor Fayemi spent 4 years there. What did he do? Just speaking English all around. And in fact, the Ajakuda, I read some of the report. Imagine Dr. Fayemi was copying existing old documents. I mean, it's so shocking. As brilliant as he is, did very little innovation, and he spent 4 years, he couldn't get Ajakuta started. And everybody gives excuses, and now you're talking about gold. I don't care about the process they've gone through, the refine to create 200 million naira. I don't care. I care about the structure, the jobs. How are you going to get companies, foreign companies, miners from Australia, from Europe, guys that have done this for decades? How do
What strategies would you then advise for the government now? So we don't seem like we also talking about the problems and not providing solutions.
So first of all, I know we have to find a way without going through an elaborate restructuring process. We have to provide greater authority to the states in terms of being able to facilitate, mining certification. I mean, let me put it that way. I don't want to say approval. So that the states can be incentivized. Second is, there has to be a way of providing incentive to that state. If you tell a state that, go through all this stress, would allow you to provide the license, but we federal government, we're going to get all the money, we're going to get all the taxes, all the royalties, then many states are not going to be encouraged. You have to find a way to provide incentives to the state without necessarily touching the restructuring issue. It could be that, tax break. It could be you can keep this amount of royalty. There has to be an incentive for state governments. Ideally, if I were a governor, I don't need an incentive because it's going to create jobs in my state. But unfortunately, we have governors that are very content with just collecting money from Abuja. And just
ready to make money from
exactly.
State.
So there has to be an incentive to encourage the state. I don't think the federal government can do it by themselves. They need the states because they need to provide security. They need the villagers. They need the local community to be supportive. They need a lot of support from the locals. So I'm not talking about Ajakuta, which is purely federal government, but there are pockets of mining happening all over Nigeria, generating billions of dollars. But because the politicians are benefiting from this legal mining, they don't want to fix it. So if this government is really honest, it shouldn't take you 4 years to revamp mining so that we can create jobs. So for me, remember, I'm focused on the job creation. If you bring in those guys from the miners, those foreign companies, they will create jobs. But if you don't do that, you allow just the illegal Chinese. I'm not talking about Chinese as a whole. Chinese have helped Nigeria a lot. But I'm talking about illegal Chinese companies working hand in hand with local communities, giving money. It's just like police, giving money back to the DPOs, to the CP, to the governors. Nothing is going to happen. So I think for me, first of all, provide incentives for the state. Second, we need honest leadership, a minister that is really honest, a minister of minds and steel, whatever it's called, that
okay.
is ready to fight, that is ready to lose his life if need be, to fight to make sure this becomes. Oh yeah, because
do you think this administration can achieve all of this that you have mentioned?
I don't
with
think
the little time remaining.
But I think that they have the capacity. It's not hard. It's not too hard. There's progress in some states. I know LRFI signed some contracts sometime. I think there's been some progress from Kaduna, to be fair to LRFI, you know. But I don't see the seriousness. I don't see the commitment of this government. It doesn't seem a priority to them. If it's a priority, you would have fixed it in 4 years. If Ajakuta were high priority to you, it would not take you 6 years. So they need to prioritize it. They need to put somebody, maybe appoint a what America would call special czar or envoy or something. If a minister cannot handle it, put it under the vice president or chief of staff and give political power to that person. Let that person go to those states and deliver on this. It can create hundreds of thousands of jobs for Nigerians. It can create billions of dollars over decades, you know. But the government has to be sincere about it, and we have to be ready to work with governors that are serious.
All right, we really have to stop here now, Engineer Onifade, because our time is really fast spent. But then we'll catch up again next week, Friday, same time, 2:30 p.m. on your favorite show, Liberating Nigeria. Well, we have to liberate Nigeria. It is in our hands. The job is in our hands. And we will keep doing all that we have to do to ensure that this country is finally set free from the shackles of okay. Thank you so much for watching today's edition of the video. Don't forget, liberatingnigeria.com is an online political forum where you can belong. That's where you can air your views, share your opinions and your thoughts on whatever is happening in the country. Unadulterated. No one is going to judge you for sharing your opinions or whatever it is you have to say. And we also urge you to send in your articles so we can publish on our platforms. You don't have to bother if you're a good writer or not. All we need from you is to be passionate about our dear country, Nigeria. Thank you so much for watching once again. My name is Deborah Yusuf. Thank you so much for your time, Engineer Onifade. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like, drop a comment, and share this video. Bye for now.
Thank you.